Seco creators, Lilu here. I'm on Ocean Drive in Miami Beach, South Beach, with Simra. Hello.
Hello. It's such a pleasure and an honor to be with you, to be playing in the sand here.
I love it. I love this woman. Oh my goodness. This makes this tour even more so special, to be meeting people like you. This is exactly what I'm looking for, what I want to share with people all around the world, and that we really see those beautiful examples happening all around us. I mean, you are the author of Your Journey to Enlightenment, Conversation with the Universe. You had this dark night, I was going to say amazing dark night of the soul, because boy, did you get a lot out of it. And you live this life really, how would you describe your life and how you live it now compared to how you were living it before?
Freedom. I live a life of freedom now, which I think is what we're all looking for. Yeah. And I live a life of courage. Yeah. And courage to me is not the opposite of fear. It is the opposite of conformity. Because too many of us have settled in life, or we've been restricted by what we think are the paradigms in our world, rather than following our hearts and our guts and living that full, juicy, joyful passion that resides inside of us, because we make up the excuses why we can't have it.
Yeah. How do you handle now these moments of, I was going to say of truth, but these challenges, these things that don't quite work as you would imagine it, or that, you know, it's in your face?
You know, when I went through my own breakdown of life into my breakthrough, and I started seeing the numbers 11, 111, and 1111 so many times, and I started to discover that every challenge that showed up actually had a gift inside of it. And that meant that there could be no bad. There could only be good. And so regardless of what shows up in my world, when it happens, I understand that it's all good, that there's actually a doorway opening to something better. If I can look past the illusion of what is happening and actually step into, look at how a child has shown up.
You know,
my book, Your Journey to Enlightenment, is about diving back into the child that we are, and the play and the spontaneity and the wonderment that children are, because that's who we are. And look, a child showed up. What a sign and a symbol when we talk about conversations from the universe.
We have a second one coming.
It's just so perfect, and that's what I want people to understand.
It's a 92 on his t-shirt. It's 11.
And see, the signs and symbols show up everywhere for each one of us. None of us are not getting that. Yeah. And if we recognize that everything, even that which appears completely random, is actually having meaning and purpose and trying to tell us something, Then all of a sudden life becomes this magical play and this engagement and this exciting adventure. Life's supposed to be an adventure, and you can't have an adventure without some of the uphill and downhill. It has to be part of it. You can't get on a slide and you know, just climb up and not go down. And that's what we can also learn from children, is that life is meant to be this endless play in all the ways that children play, rather than attaching to the obstacles that we should have show up in our lives.
And everything is a conversation with the universe.
Everything from the people that show up in front of you, your job, what your name means, the things that happen to your house. If a pipe bursts, that's there to tell you something about you. If you have a flat tire, depending on which side of the car, it's there to tell you something about you. If your child has an illness, the very age that child has that illness and the specific illness is there to tell you something about you. You're not on a journey. You are the journey. You're not in the world. You're every piece and part of the world. You're not this human being or even this spiritual being. You're experiencing itself. And the reason I want people to really get that is because you have the power to really create it however you want it, and you already have. Those things outside of you don't really exist. There's only one here, and it happens to be you. And when you get that, and you get that everything outside of you is another representation or another reincarnation of you, including your challenges, then all of a sudden you're realizing the only one that you're really dealing with is yourself.
Mm. At some point, as we're evolving through this journey, it feels like are the people outside not understanding even the journey that we're on. It's like, why do you try to make a meaning to everything that happens to you and this and that? And there's this whole other side of Earth or people we're meeting. It feels feels like we're trying to pull us back, you know? How do you deal with that, trying to make sense and at the same time still being spontaneous and living without analyzing or intellectualizing? How do you follow your heart in those moments?
You know, they're the most beautiful gifts because they are there to be the obstacle so that we truly follow our hearts and follow our souls. And if they're expressing any doubts, you cannot hear something outside of you that does not exist within you. So when you hear those doubts, rather than fighting it or having it stop you, check in. Where is that doubt in me? Because it couldn't have been spoken unless I had it inside of me. Those situations outside are meant to slow us down. Because we chose to learn certain things. I chose to come in here to learn my creative capacity. I wanted to discover my beauty. I wanted to discover connection and union. But to do that, I had to create 44 years of some pretty intense pain. I had to know ugliness. I had to know weakness. I had to know complete disconnection. That's where the ember sat, in that dark place of my life. So it was necessary for me to then now step into this place that allows me to fully express and understand that anything can be created and discover the beauty of my life in all its forms and the power and presence that I possess. It's for me to celebrate me so that I also can celebrate other people, celebrate those that are also expressing in that way.
Yeah.
Because I can't see it in you unless I see it in myself first.
Give us an example that comes to your mind, because you have many, and obviously you go around the United States and the world now, because boy, are you get so many stories and talent and the voice to share with others what's really happening here on Earth. Like you're the witness and the, how do you say, and the actor and the director.
Even the audience, even the set, we're all of that. And the best way that I can explain that is to actually tell a story that happened on the Rebel Road when we first left. When we left, I had manifested an RV. I was given a vision that we would go out on the road, that I was to put on a show in 66 cities. I was to sing and do humor and speak, things I'd never done before because I've been a shy hermit locked inside my house for the last 44 years because that was the only way I could deal with the pain and the abuse and the different things that were happening in my house. And so I just didn't go out and see people. I didn't connect with people, even though it looked like it with 11/11 and all the things that I did. And so I was given this guidance to go on the road, to take my two children and to spontaneously put on these shows, places that I would be invited. I wasn't even supposed to plan it. Within three weeks of us leaving, the RV showed up. Within 1 week of us leaving, 42 cities showed up and invited me, and we embarked. And just after leaving, I had to stop for gas and the RV wouldn't crank. And so we got it jump started, went to the next place where we camped out, and the RV wouldn't start again the next morning. So we had to go to a service station, and they started working on it. I thought, okay, great, I'm going to acquire a bill now of about $700, and it's not how I wanted to start. And they wanted to know what this was all about.
So you had that fear pop up.
Yes.
I mean, you had, some people say, oh, but you know, your negative thoughts and this and that, they prevent you from manifesting your divine. But actually, it's good that you mentioned that. That thought pop up in your mind.
Of course, those are going to pop up because the mind wants to play in that way. Even before this venture began, I had the thoughts that most of us have. I can't do this. I have two kids. How am I going to take them on the road? Who's going to teach them? I don't have the money. I've just left all the security that I know. I'm not smart enough, good enough. I don't know how to do this. Maybe I'm too old. Maybe I won't be accepted. All those things that we say, you know, are those fears that come in. But we have to step beyond that and say, well, I'm willing to try anyway. I'm willing to step into the unknown. Yeah. And what the Rebel Road and the Creative Rebel represent is that there's nothing to save, fix, or heal on the outside. There's also nothing to save, fix, or heal here. It's all divine, so it all can fix itself. What we are supposed to do is dive into our hearts and our passions. I'm not here as a teacher or a guru. I don't want to be a teacher or a guru. Honestly, there are many teachers and gurus out there right now that need to learn some of the lessons of the golden age themselves.
Even if you're Indian?
Even if you're Indian, yes. I don't need to be that. What I do want to be and desire to be is the example. And I think that that's what each of us have the opportunity to be, so that we give permission to others to do the same.
Yeah.
And as I walk my journey and trust the universe by the signs and symbols that show up, everything has shown up. And just in this case, I got the RV fixed. They said it was a piece called the solenoid, which is the communication box between the ignition and the engine. And it tells the engine that you've ignited. And so they replaced this, but instead of getting a bill, they ended up coming to me saying, the bill is waived. Here's $200 for your what you're doing because we believe in it. And I was on my way. I got to the next place where the first show was supposed to happen, and the RV wouldn't crank once I got our space where we were supposed to park. So I thought, well, the universe must be trying to tell me the first message in the first show. So what's happening? And I stepped back and I took a breath, and we will always get the answer. And the first word that came into my head was solenoid. And so I started chanting that word over and over and over again, solenoid, solenoid, solenoid. And it turned into silly noise, silly noise, silly noise. And I realized, I bet it's all of the voices outside of us and the voices inside our own head that keeps us stopping and starting and stopping and starting to not live our dreams. Universe, is that the conversation you're trying to give me to share? So I got back in the driver's seat and I cranked up the RV, and it cranked ever since. We really are that connected to our world, to everything in our world. And so when something happens, like a flat tire, a car crash, something that breaks down in our house, a relationship breakdown, an illness to our child, a health issue with our pet, rather than falling into the illusion of, oh my goodness, why did this happen? How did this happen? What am I
gonna do? It's not fair.
Exactly. How am I going to pay for this? If we could step back for a second and say, where is this in me? What is it trying to show me beyond the illusion? Then all of a sudden, within that, you're going to find different messages and gifts. And those messages and gifts, actually that occurrence, was there to take you to the next step. The same thing happened with my magazine. Once I was downloaded with that and had it all typed out, my computer crashed. But I had just asked for a graphic designer, and I told the universe to bring him to me. So how else was it going to happen? But for me to bring someone in that was then going to bring me the graphic designer, so the computer had to crash. And then that person that came to fix the computer said, this is an amazing thing that you're about to do. Do you happen to need a graphic designer? And she showed up.
Yeah.
So the universe always conspires on our behalf, but we don't understand that love has many ways that it can show up.
I have the same graphic designer story, you know, with Linda Mangoro that created this beautiful design and has supported me for many years. And I just did one for the Sri Lanka because I'm heading to Sri Lanka on the Juicy Tour. I'm flying there in a week, and I'm wearing a sari. And Linda showed up after a breakdown too, finding not the right one.
That's how it works. And I know you have many stories too. And it's about understanding that we all get signs and symbols, every single one of us. None of us are void of that. And if you're not seeing the 11-11s, you're seeing something. And when you see that symbol, what you are to do is to close your eyes, disconnect the brain, take a breath, drop into your heart and gut, and see what you're thinking about in exactly that moment. Because the universe is trying to pay attention to that. And it's asking you to follow your heart, not pay attention to your mind or any of the doubts, because the universe has your back. The universe always has your back. And the more you take a step every time you get that conversation, then you engage the conversation in a deeper way. And then the universe will send more signs and symbols, and you'll take more steps. And then doors will open, and people will come into your lives, and then you'll take more steps. And that's how your journey has been. Things have happened every step of the way that you've needed. That's what has happened with me, regardless of not having anything. I stepped out on trust, and everything I've needed has shown up.
Yeah. Are those the veils, you know, what, because you speak of those veils that not need to be removed, but that we maybe live through?
Yes, and I don't think the veils are outside of us. I think a lot of people speak about these veils that exist. All the veils are inside, and those veils actually are the beliefs and thoughts and systems and paradigms that we've bought into. And once we get past that and we say, I no longer choose to be who I know. I'm going to step out of being this identity, this personality, this ego, and discover who I've never been. Because the only way my life was going to change beyond where it was for me to be willing to say, I don't know how to do these things. I've never done them before in my life. But what if they are a part of me? If the divine presence is all things and in all things, and I too am the divine presence walking just like you, you are the divine presence walking. Lilu's the divine presence walking. Then what is it that we cannot do? Nothing. We should be able to do everything. We are here as creative capacity. Most importantly, we are here as experience, experiencing itself. And we hold the divine back from expressing because we don't let ourselves move beyond our own fears. The one point that most people say is, I'm too afraid. I can tell you every step of the way in the last 5-month journey on the Rebel Road, when I have passed a mirror, I have looked in that mirror and said, what the heck are you doing? Have you gone nuts? I've said that. And then I stop and I take a breath and I look back at the mirror and something inside of me says, you know exactly what you're doing. And if we would give ourselves that second glance, we would see that there's a voice within that says, you don't think you know, but you do. Because we all have it.
You say we are all masters?
We are all masters. No one better or below the other. We are all just as special and not so. We are each masters walking. And a master is not someone that creates miracles all around them and has no problems. A master is someone that navigates and flows through any obstacles that shows up. A master is someone that understands that the world is around here on our behalf, showing us who we are. Everything in the world is you speaking back to you as you for your own self-realization. And that is a master.
If we could summarize to end this beautiful interview that can go on for hours and hours, and I can't wait to read those books and discover more. And if you want to see more, of course, there's a whole website and plenty of things there that you've decided actually to put for free. So this is one of another expression of this divine, huh? And the TEDx. I love your TED Talk.
Thank you. Thank you. That's amazing.
So what is, if we can summarize this, what is for you this enlightened being? Is that really, is enlightened living, you know, is this really what this time is about here on Earth?
It is about stepping into our mastery. At age 11, each one of us had some significant experience that either kept us on our soul path or diverted us off of it. It was either the birth of another child, the death of someone, a health issue, a big move, something that rocked your world to such a degree. And every double-digit age that you have tries to remind you of the truth of your mastery. We are in the golden age now, where we're each meant to be examples of experience experiencing itself. You are in a world that is in the field of love all of the time. It's of the field of love all of the time. It is with love all of the time. You are simply here to be as love all of the time. Your conversations with the universe are constant. What you have to develop is trust. And as in my book, Conversations with the Universe, it illustrates how to develop that trust by everything that's showing up in your world speaking back to you. Once you gain a level of trust with the world around you, then all of a sudden it's time to step into courage. And courage means stepping out of conformity, out of bondage, out of the replication of society, out of the servitude that has all been self-imposed, and then inviting enlightenment into you. You're the only one that can invite your own enlightenment. It cannot be given to you anyone outside of you. Even the universe can't give it to you because you are that universe. And when you invite, invoke, initiate that enlightenment inside of yourself and step beyond those limitations, you will step back into the play, the lightness and the humor of the divine child, and that's where your enlightenment rests. And that's the book, Your Journey to Enlightenment.
Beautiful. And I hear in the background the plane. I think
we're
it's time for
off.
Yeah, we're taking off.
Fine.
And also the universe is reminding us, you're flying back to Texas, I'm flying back to Europe today. We're heading back to the Miami airport right now.
Yeah. Look at the signs. It just conspires to assist us along. We can be that much in the now that we don't need clocks or direction or anything.
Beautiful. Thank you. It's an honor to have met you and interviewed you. Really
thank
special.
Thank you, Lilu. Thank you for all that you do in the world.
And thank you, my all my juicy co-creators watching this video, for sharing this. This is exactly the type of conversation that needs to spread wildly all around the world. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Yes.
And thank you to all of you for seeing that beautiful divine spark in you. Big, big kisses. Love
Bye-bye.
You. Bye.
life of freedom now, which I think is what we're all looking for.
Yeah.
And I live a life of courage.
Yeah.
And courage to me is not the opposite of fear. It is the opposite of conformity, because too many of us have settled in life, or we've been restricted by what we think are the paradigms in our world, rather than following our hearts and our guts and living that full, juicy, joyful passion that resides inside of us, because we make up the excuses why we can't have it.
Yeah. How do you handle now these moments of, I was going to say, of truth, people all around the world, and that we really see those beautiful examples happening all around us? I mean, you are the author of Your Journey to Enlightenment, Conversation with the Universe. You had this dark night, I was going to say amazing dark night of the soul, because boy, did you get a lot out of it. And you live this life really, how would you describe your life and how you live it now compared to how you were living it before?
Freedom. I live a
Juicy Co-Creators, Lilu here. I'm on Ocean Drive in Miami Beach, South Beach, with Simra. Hello.
Hello. It's such a pleasure and an honor to be with you, to be playing in the sand here.
I love it. I love this woman. Oh my goodness. This makes this tour even more so special, to be meeting people like you. This is exactly what I'm looking for, what I want to share with, but these challenges, these things that don't quite work as you would imagine it, or that, you know, it's in your face.
You know, when I went through my own breakdown of life into my breakthrough, and I started seeing the numbers 11, 111, and 11, 11 so many times, and I started to discover that every challenge that showed up actually had a gift inside of it. And that meant that there could be no bad. There could only be good. And so regardless of what shows up in my world, when it happens,